From the Fraser Valley Regional District, Representative Director Orion Engar.
By providing this space here at Thompson Regional Park, we are very happy that the history and honor of those individuals who gave their lives in the service to our country will now be preserved as their spirit and their memory lives on here, cradled in the arms of the mountains.
At the going down of the sun, and in the morning, we shall remember them. Thank you.
A man is not truly dead until he is forgotten. Honored guests, I am very proud to be the spark that lit the fire that fueled the energy that got the project done. My role is a very small one, but I'm very proud of it. This, in fact, goes back...
This is the part of the ceremony that I really like. These are the family and friends of the men who died. At this time, I'd like to call upon Francis Langlands, who's come all the way from Norway.
Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Francis Langlands Kohler, and David Robertson Langlands was my uncle. I have lived the last 48 years in Norway, and as you know, Norway was occupied by the Germans during the Second World War. I would like to read out the names of the Canadian airmen whose graves are beside my Norwegian family's graves and who are now resting in a foreign country. They are flying officers.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Faye Jenkin and I'm a niece of Sergeant David Robertson Langlands. My sister Frances and I are here to represent our family, past and present, in Scotland, England, Norway and Canada. My Uncle David is the eldest of five children.
Leonard Gordon Hammond, for him and for us, it has been a long journey to get here. Not only has it been a journey from New Zealand, for ourselves and the other families here today, it's also the journey involved in the construction of this wonderful monument in their memories. And also, for us, or myself, as the only Hammond family member to ever have visited this particular site, to pay tribute to the Hammond family member who was killed.
The next person that we have is Derek Watson. He comes to us from Victoria, British Columbia, and it's my great honor to ask him to come up and speak to us.
Sergeant David Robertson Langlands, during your lifetime, you may meet some people who will impact and influence the path that you will follow. David was one of those. David was a close family friend, neighbor, and mentor. Our family shared the same residence from 1939 to 1945. David had served as a police officer with the Grampian Police for over 10 years in Aberdeen, Scotland. Married to Einar Bannerman for just 2 months before the outbreak of war. Later, when David entered the RAF, we were all relieved to find that he was being posted to Canada for further training. Safe haven. From his letters, you could tell that he loved Canada and the people that he had met here. In 1945, after the victory in Europe was declared, we were looking forward to David's imminent homecoming. Sadly, this was not to be. Although I followed to Canada 5 years later, it was not until retirement that I became aware of the details regarding the final outcome of flight KK241. In 1999, with the help of Brian Walton, a local documentary filmmaker here in Chilliwack, he led me to the base of Mount Welsh and to the cairn erected by cadets in 1983. Strong emotions were present that day at the cairn, reading the names on the stainless steel plaque and wondering what could have been for these young men, had they been spared. After a while, a period of serene calm seemed to settle over this small alpine clearing. I placed a wreath in memory of David and his crew. It was 10 a.m. It was June 1st. It was 54 years later, almost to the minute. In closing, my sincere appreciation and thanks to Lieutenant Ron Shure for spearheading this whole project. My thanks to the Air Cadets of 147 Air Wolf Squadron and Air Cadets of 861 Silver Fox Squadron, their former commander Chris Waite, Canadian Legion Branch number 280, 192nd Airfield Engineers. My thanks to everybody who has been involved in presenting this beautiful monument to these very brave men. Thank you.
Part of the ceremony is the laying of the wreath. Our next Sergeant is Albert Aaron Rockin, LA.
Don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day.
Sergeant John Randall.
Just like you always do, till the blue skies drive the dark clouds far away. So will you please say hello to the folks that I know? Tell them I won't be long. Don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day.